All right, so today I want to talk to you guys a little bit about a mindset shift that you can start to make to view your weight loss journey differently than maybe you have in the past. So most times people approach their weight loss with the idea that something needs to be lost, right? We're losing weight. So we're approaching it from the sense of I'm trying to shed a part of myself away from myself. This is a very dangerous place to be, because when we're in this mentality, we're not actually just isolating the idea of weight off of our body. We're actually pushing away the parts of ourself that we have been rejecting about ourselves, which is the reason why we choose to eat our feelings, and which is why we've chosen to, or which is why we've gained weight in the first place. So when it's a very subconscious way of looking at this, because when we are rejecting our body, we're actually rejecting the parts of ourselves that we don't like that got us into that body in the first place. It might not seem like there's a connection, but there's definitely a connection there. So what I want to do is I want to help you guys understand that part of this, the weight loss journey, is going to be about looking at it through a new lens. Because when we push these aspects of ourselves away, right? I need to lose this. I need to move away from this. It's a form of self-rejection. We're actually rejecting ourselves. And what that leads us to is it may lead you into stepping into your dream body, but it's not going to allow you to step into your dream life, which is going to have acceptance and confidence and security in who you are, because those don't come from how we look, right? Those don't come from how much fat we have on our body, right? Your worth is not determined by your weight. So when we start to step into this beautiful energy to which we are, we start to notice that it's not about what we look like. It's not about how much weight we have on our bodies. It's about how we feel about ourselves, right? So when we're pushing away these aspects of ourselves, this self-rejection is actually sending messages to ourselves that we're not good enough. And then we start to try harder and harder, and we develop almost like this perfectionism or this sense of this unworthiness. It's fueling our perfectionism, and we feel like we have to keep doing and doing and doing until we can finally get to that place where we feel worth. This is the trap of weight loss that people get caught in, where they eventually maybe get to their goal weight if they don't sabotage themselves along the way, and they realize that they're actually not happy. They're not truly authentically happy, because what they were chasing all along was their dream body, not their dream life. So what we need to do in this journey is we actually need to invite in a new question. Instead of how much am I going to lose on this journey, it's what can I gain on this journey, right? What can you gain on this journey that's gonna get you to where you need to be in all aspects of your being, right? So asking yourself the question, what can I gain? What can I gain in the physical realm of my being, the emotional realm, the mental realm, and the spiritual realm of my being? What can I gain that's going to carry me forward? So and by this, I mean habits. I mean learnings, knowledge, skills, all of these things that you're going to need that are going to teach you authentic self-worth, authentic self-love, and authentic self-acceptance. These are very important things that when you get to your goal weight, if you are in absence of those things, you're not going to feel a sense of accomplishment, because you're lacking the main ingredients to a successful transformation and to a successful life and to feeling good about yourself, right? Those three things are so crucial in order for us to be happy. So I want you to ask yourself that question. What do I have to gain on this journey? And start framing it differently than how you have been, because what most people do is they're sending a message to themselves of rejection, of abandonment. I'm not good enough, so I have to keep working. Whereas it's like, you know what? Instead of looking at it like that, what do I have to shed and push away from my being? What can I invite into my being, right? And to complement who I already am. Because we can't run from the things that we are, right? We have shortcomings, we have weaknesses, we have habits that we're caught in that we might not like about ourselves. But the more we push and resist these things and try and reject them, the more that they persist and they become part of us, because we have to learn to resolve these things. It's not about erasing them. It's about resolving them, and it's about bringing in new things to complement you, to assist in your transformation. And that's why I'm not a huge fan of the word change. Right? Change really gives the idea of needing to be fixed, like something's broken, right? We need to change it out because it's broken, whereas transformation is about accumulation, right? It's about expansion, and it's about looking at what do I already have, what do I already possess that is made me who I am, and what can I bring in to make me even more awesome, and so I can step into this person that I want to be. So ask yourself that question, what do I have to gain on this journey? And start to write those things down. What do you want to gain? What do you want to be at the end of your transformation? Because if you don't know that now, other than I want to be 30 pounds lighter, like that's fantastic, right? You're going to feel confident in your body, but you won't feel confident in your emotional self, in your spiritual self, and in your mental self. This is that biggest aspect of this transformation. So start to ask that, invite that in. And start to create intention around what you want to experience at the end of your journey, and start cultivating that now.